I am Dr. H.M.P. Singh of Mallikka Manipal Medical College. In this presentation, we are going to show you laser therapy by helium neon and nitrogen laser as an adjuvant in patients of resistant pulmonary tuberculosis. The aim of this therapy is to assess the bactericidal effect of nitrogen and immune modulatory effect of helium neon laser as an adjuvant in patients of resistant pulmonary tuberculosis, and the same were assessed in clinical, bacteriological, hematological and radiological. Before the advent of anti-tubercular drugs, people used to treat tuberculosis with electric currents, formaldehyde, radium, thorium and other agents apart from good food, sunlight and fresh air. Dr. Niels Riebeck Finsen treated skin tuberculosis successfully by UV rays. Laser came into existence in late 20th century, and helium neon and nitrogen laser started being used in these trials. Significant improvement was observed in laser group as compared to control. Overall improvement was observed in 75% of the cases as compared to 25% in control. After the advent of laser in 1960 by Dr. Maimon, it has been used in various applications in surgery and also ophthalmoscopy. 1988, the laser in low-level laser therapy was found, and helium neon laser was the first one to be used in medicine. In this clinical trial, helium neon laser was given intravenously for 600 seconds, 3 days per week for 10 sessions, and nitrogen laser was given into the lungs for 600 seconds at weekly interval for 10 sessions. In this patient, the local anesthesia is given and intravenous helium neon laser is being given through a Jelco cannula. In this patient, the local anesthesia is being given after the aseptic precautions, and the procedure is carried out after the local anesthesia. The syringe with 10 ml normal saline and the Jelco cannula is being induced at the site of lesion, and then we are pushing the needle inside while pulling the syringe and look for gush of air. The moment the gush of air is seen, you need to stop and then take out the syringe and then pull the laser fiber and insert the laser fiber along with the black bush for entrapment of the air. Then the laser therapy is being given for 600 seconds and the patient is comfortable. As you can see the results, the clinical parameters, fever, cough, weight, well-being, all have shown improvement in laser group compared to the controls. The same are compared in this graph, in which you can see that fever, weight, cough, sense of well-being, all have shown significant improvement compared to the controls. The bacteriological improvement, which is the gold standard for treatment of tuberculosis, has shown significant improvement in this trial. In the initial 2 weeks, we have seen maximum improvement in laser group compared to the control group. And you can see that 68% of the patients have shown no improvement in control group compared to the laser. The radiological improvement was seen maximum in unilateral cavities and also bilateral cavities. The multiple cavity did not show the similar improvement as compared to unilateral and bilateral cavities, and this was much more than the control group. Thus, the overall improvement was seen in all the parameters in laser group as compared to control, and these patients have shown improvement up to 75% as compared to control. In conclusion, we see that significant clinical improvement, bacterial sterility radiological improvement is seen in laser group as compared to the control. As an adjuvant, laser therapy is successful. In future, laser therapy can be used if there is a policy, training, aggressive approach. And not only it will be useful in fresh tuberculosis and positive cases of tuberculosis, but also in MDR, PTB with HIV and also endobronchial tuberculosis.